Hello everyone, this is your guy Rajat from RenStudios.com. So a few days back I did a video about which laptop you should buy for programming purposes, and in that video I have talked about MacBooks, right? So today I am back with yet another video where I will show you the performance of my MacBook Air. Now this MacBook Air is at least 4 years old. I purchased this MacBook in mid-2013, and that was the current model back then. Okay, so it has 4 GB of RAM and Intel i5 Haswell processor. Okay, so let me show you like what I can do using this Mac. So I can run all of the system utility program without any problem, but as a developer, you must be worried about whether you will be able to run programming heavy applications or IDEs like Xcode or Android Studio, right? So what I will do in this video is I will launch everything side by side and I will let you judge that whether MacBook Airs are capable enough to handle all of your app development activities or not. So let's quickly head over to Xcode. Let's launch it. Okay, so we have launched Xcode and let's quickly open this project. So we have opened Xcode, right? So let's quickly run this project as well, and we have our iOS simulator started as well. All right, so our app is all booted up and ready to run, and as you can see that I can record things and I can play with my application on my iOS simulator. Now this is a sample application and I developed it using tutorials from Udacity, which you can check out because these tutorials are really helpful in learning iOS development. Okay, so we have our Xcode and iOS simulator booted up with our application running inside our iOS simulator. Now let's launch Android Studio side by side while iOS or Xcode is running. Now let me tell you that the boot time of Android Studio is way faster as compared to my Windows laptop, which is having 8 GB of RAM. Maybe you can attribute the fast boot up time to the SSD, I don't know, but yes, SSDs are very fast as compared to 5400 RPM hard drives. Okay, so our Android Studio is all ready to open our project, and maybe we can quickly open this test project which I have created. All right. So our Android Studio is all booted up and ready to run the emulator. So let's quickly, okay, it is indexing as of now. So it will take some time for Gradle to set everything up. But yes, the editor is ready. We can go and edit some files like this, right? So the editor is ready, but the Gradle is taking time. So it is something related to Gradle, not Android Studio. And we can quickly, you know, switch between the applications, right? So it is as responsive as that. And I can go to Xcode and do all of the things, right? Gradle really takes a lot of time. Okay. So meanwhile, the Gradle is building everything up. Maybe we can look into the project itself and we can do some edits and all while Gradle is indexing, because you know it is Gradle, so you have to wait no matter what system you are using. And we can, before starting this video, I was writing some Swift code, so maybe we can try running that code. And as you can see that you can run this code side by side, it is also compiling. Okay, so as you can see that there is the output from this code. Okay, so let's get back to Android Studio and see whether it has finished or not. So it has finished. Now Gradle build is running, but yeah, as you can see that everything is responsive enough, unlike my Windows or Ubuntu system. Everything is very much responsive. My iOS simulator is working fine and I can do everything, and there is a little bit of lag, but that is, you know, expected, because you are running resource intensive applications side by side, and in most of the cases you won't be running all of these applications all at the same time. Maybe you are working on iOS application and for that time period you will only work exclusively on Xcode, and when you are working on Android application you will exclusively work on Android Studio, and there will hardly be a case when you need to open both of the apps simultaneously. But I'm showing you so that you get the idea of how capable MacBook Air 2013 is. So if you are purchasing something newer than this, you can expect even better performance than this, and I am quite happy with my MacBook Air's performance. Okay, so let's get back to okay, so we are in Android Studio now. Let's quickly launch the emulator. So our Android emulator is all booted up and our app is running inside our Android emulator. And as you can see that I can click through all parts of the application and the emulator is responsive, and you can see it is quite responsive. It can be faster than this, but yes, I am pretty happy with the performance I am getting from my MacBook Air. And you can switch between the emulators, so you can run the emulator side by side. I use this sort of setup while testing my new application Kivia. So I wanted to test whether my application or the website is working fine in both the Safari and the Chrome browser for mobile operating system, and I wanted to test everything side by side. So that is when I decided to load Android Studio on my MacBook Air so that I can boot up an Android simulator and I can test everything side by side. And I was quite happy to see that everything worked out so fine that now I can go out and test everything side by side. And as you can see that I am testing my application side by side, right? So I can go out and chat, right? So as you can see that everything is working fine, right? So the performance I am getting from my MacBook Air, which is having 4 GB of RAM and Intel Core i5 Haswell processor, and it is a model of mid 2013, which is a 4-year old model, so I cannot expect more from this sort of thing. So I hope now that you might have got some kind of idea about whether this sort of setup is good for you or not. Like, you can run everything side by side and the system is still performant enough. You can, you know, switch between the application and do everything and just do and run all of your normal application side by side while doing all of the development things. So with that, this is your guy Rajat Saxena signing off, and make sure you subscribe to this channel because I produce weekly computer science and software development industry related videos, and make sure to share this video with someone who is still deciding whether he or she should get a MacBook Air or Pro or not, right? So with that, I'm just signing off. Take care. Bye-bye.